All right, obviously, pretty historic night for Oklahoma City. Results clearly coming in exactly how you wanted it. What's your immediate reaction just seeing, you know, the margin of victory in this?
Incredibly excited for our city. Obviously, a win was a win, but to move forward with this margin, a historic margin in our city's history, I mean, it really represents a consensus. You know, it's a mandate. It's validation that we're on the right track. So, yeah, I'm absolutely thrilled for our city. Just can't believe almost that we really get to have this renaissance continue in some ways for another generation, and we can build upon this platform now, knowing that we're a big league city.
In your speech earlier, you mentioned how the world was watching this election and what Oklahoma City voters decided. Kind of recap that and just how important this is on the level of worldwide, but not just important here in Oklahoma.
Well, I think for 15 years, people have seen, have considered us a curiosity, right? We're still kind of a small market. Do we really deserve a team? Can we really play with the big boys? Do we have the guts to make the commitment that you have to make to play at this level? And not only to just pass it, but to pass it like this. I mean, people are going to have to stand back and say, okay, Oklahoma City's here to stay. And I love that, obviously. I love this city. And I love that I think we made such a strong statement tonight that this is a global city and we're not going anywhere.
The biggest question now that this has passed that I know a lot of people are going to want to know, you know, the Thunder's here till 2050. Where's the new arena going to go? Is there any, you know, decision or early decisions in that, what you expect?
I think that definitely has to be sort of the first order of business, and there's a process and we got to really get into it. You know, I think that's clearly the task of 2024. If we want to stay on a timeline of opening this in 2029 as the letter of intent stated, we need to, you know, probably get this part resolved pretty soon, and then we'll move into design, which in and of itself is probably a couple year process. Construction is probably a couple year process. You know, for all the excitement tonight, you know, we do need now to like sit down and hurry up and wait, you know, because this arena is not opening tomorrow. We're going to have some amazing memories still created at the arena that we have while this process unfolds. But I think it's an exciting opportunity. I think it's going to be a lot of fun to design it. I think it's going to be a unique statement about Oklahoma City, and I think it's really going to raise the bar in our community. So we have all that to look forward to, and obviously at the end of that journey, a ribbon cutting, but I'll have a few more gray hairs at that point.
Do you have any inspiration for the arena in terms of what you expect it to look like or businesses surrounding it, anything like that?
Well, listen, I mean, at the dollar amount and at the square footage that we're talking about, 750,000 square feet compared to what we have today, like 550,000 square feet. And when you look at modern NBA arenas, I mean, it's going to be obviously much, much larger in every way, every direction. And if we do this right, it's going to be a statement piece. It's going to raise the bar architecturally in our community. I mean, people, we're going to be driving our cousins here when they visit. We're going to say, look at our very nice arena. And they're going to say, that's the arena of a big city, you know? And that's obviously what we want. I think that way you felt when Scissortail Park opened, when the convention center opened, wow, the city's never been the same and the city's never looked this great. You know, that's what we want to obviously feel with this project.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you. Congrats to yourself.